Alright guys, this is Paraleo and welcome to the Land of Lions. Okay, so OBS pulled a fast one on me. Sometimes it changes settings and audio sources and other technical stuff that you don't understand. The problem is I played till Enbesa, until I arrived to Enbesa. And yeah, the expedition is quite fun. I actually read some stuff over there, so it... all that work went to the garbage, guys. So you can hear me in that recording, but you can't hear anything from the game. So I would suspect that thing would not be very nice to watch. So let's do it again. I will try to make all my choices again, but probably I won't be reading the expedition text out loud anymore, because I already did that once and sorry about that, but I'll probably read the stuff in bold. Okay, now let's set up a ship and go.
Let's extend the old telescope.
Yes, we will use freedom. We will use freedom. Yeah, so it's a nice trip over there. Actually, the events happen at, let's say, 2 minutes between each one of them, so you don't have to wait that much. Let's say max 2 minutes, I would say. Yeah, but we can fast forward from the first event to the next event and so on. We are going to send the Great Eastern over there. Let's prepare it for an expedition. Let's put only people with tons of stuff over there. Yeah. Man, sadly, I'm actually sad that you couldn't see the first reaction, because I had so much fun over there. So this one is going to be a second playthrough, so it's not gonna be that cool. Am I recording though? Okay. Yeah, I'm sad. And I check usually all the times, so this time I haven't checked. Yeah. So bummed out. It's good that I didn't upload that, and yeah. I checked it before. Anyway, let's focus on the task at hand. Let's put some ship items on this one. Let's get big bonuses, because we are going... oh, it's for military ships. Yes, we are going to keep the Eastern over there. So let's allow him to stay there. He doesn't have too many bonuses though. This one, we have many copies of him, so he has good bonuses for expeditions, so we are keeping him here. Also, I would like to get the Pope. Where's the Pope? See, I have one over here, and I think I have one in Trelawney. It's more than you need. Actually, I don't even need him, because I have so much cash. Maybe for the construction costs, because you need less things. 50 and 30. Cool. We take you also. So navigation is on point. Navigation crafting 50. Diplomacy, okay, for now we are good. Let's get, I wanted this one. Yeah, let's see, force, naval power, let's take this one, even though no, we are taking stuff that he can keep. Actually, the expedition is easy. It's actually an easy level for the expedition, as you can see over here. So you can fail some stuff, but not that much. In fact, let's get prices,
Better desire
even
to
though.
withstood an attack.
Let's get slowdown. Yeah, basically for a trade ship. Because later we can, I understand we can build another Great Eastern. After we get that research going and we gain permits to build a new one and a new one, and you need a new permit for another one, and so on. So they allow you to build more. Let's see. Now I do want to get. So keep your volume down a bit because I tend to get very excited usually and I forget the voice levels sometimes. And now let's get the town hall item. Let's get the Pope. Yeah, get the Pope. Yes. Don't think we'll keep him there, but still. And now we are getting goods. Okay, so let's get some champagne. I think with this we have diplomacy at 80 level, so we are just dandy. Even though he has diplomacy also. You know what? We could use a hunter also. I don't think I have somebody with medicine force. Yeah, we got some items. I got some items. Some were green, some were blue, some were stuff that I didn't have, some more new stuff. And I got an extra thing, a cool thing. Let's hope I remember how to do the same that event again. I got one legendary out of everything. We'll see how it goes, okay? I think we are fine without hunting though. Let's get only goods. So we have this. This. Let's actually do it another way, because assign ship. The name of the ship is Freedom. Oh, let's kick a cattle ship. This one I'm. No Condor. Connoisseur. Black Swan. Blobfish. Where is that? Freedom. Okay, we are pretty much covered. So we have 50 faith. Diplomacy. We have a ton. Faith crafting, we have 50. Diplomacy, we have over 100. Let's see if somebody gives faith. Diplomacy, you are hypnotist also. Diplomacy hunting. Diplomacy medicine. Medicine force. But I do want faith. Somebody with faith and medicine. Don't know, do we have somebody? Let's see. Medicine and force is good also, because you need force. Okay, let's put them over here and I'll pick a few of them. This guy, I took this guy last time. But not that much force in this guy. Navigation we have, crafting we have already. Crafting force, trade military ship. I think this can be used over here. This fate. Now I want something with more crafting. Naval power, diplomacy, guys, really. Only crafting, diplomacy. Okay, we are stopping soon, because... So actually finished the trip with over 90% morale. So I would say... No, we can't have 4 people, because I don't want to give a legendary for what we get. So let's pick 3 out of this. This I want. This... Navigation 40, diplomacy, diplomacy. This one gives 34s. Okay, let's get them. I have tons of this, so I can afford to throw them overboard. What else do we have? A lot. In ditch water. This hunting. Last time I took cigars and champagne. But we have tons of diplomacy, so we don't really need it. What's this? Pemmican, extra rations, construction material. I took a bunch of this, which gives us naval power. Bonus navigation. Yeah, let's give it like this. I think this will work though. Okay, let's go like this. Let's go like this and actually we are going to prepare a bit ahead, because I watched some streams. I didn't want to ruin most of the content, you know, but I do know a bit about the buildings that are coming. I didn't want to ruin the story though, that was important for me, because I want to play it myself. And I don't know much about the story, I just know there are important decisions with branches. So you have to be careful what you pick. There seems to be a good pick and a bad pick at many points in the story, so we have to be careful and read all about it. Okay, what else? I know a bit about production lines, so I know the elders, which are the second tier of civilization in Enbesa. They require glasses and they require cotton, but I just don't remember if it's processed cotton or raw cotton, you know. Yeah, it's not my war, it's the others are. I just keep trading rights with them. I would say this is the best way to treat the players around here.
How wonderful. You've taken pity on us.
Okay. Request non-aggression pact, even though the pirates can break your non-aggression pact if they don't like you. And they don't care about stuff like that. But these guys do care about them, they don't break them. Okay, and this is it. They do have more military power, but that's because they have many cannons around, Okay, but yeah, because as I said, I played the other time and the game counted that. I would say it's more than 4 hours. No. So let me finish what I was saying. Come on, man. Oh, man. So they have more military power because they have more fixed cannons than I do. I barely have any. If I would build at every island that I own, I probably would reach 600 and stuff like that. But they just have them anywhere and that adds up to the military power, okay? But I think I have the bigger military fleet over here. Now, let me show my town. It's all functional. I have about 40,000 investors. 25 are over here. And the rest are on the other big island in the other session. It's just functional. I haven't finished setting it up. Everything in my session is okay, it won't be long now until we get the first event. Everything in my session contains campaign maps because I wanted to have them all in my main thing, even though, by example, in the south you have this empty space over here which is not used. I chose to keep it. Okay. Also, let them expand a bit. I took some of the islands, just enough. You don't need everything unless you are going for 1 million investors, which I will never do because it's just too much. And I play a ton of other games also, so I need to balance things out. Yeah. So mostly the islands are functional, the investors are well taken care of, except for the coffee, which I postponed to get until the Land of Lions. Alright. Now, this is Crown Falls. As you can see, they are all added over here just for numbers. And I am planning to rearrange the island if I find time to take care of it. But for a few days I will focus only on Enbesa, and I will ignore this completely. The Arctic is well set up. They don't need anything but coffee, of course. Where is that? On 4. Actually, the Arctic, I didn't let the other AI take anything from this place. It's set up almost perfectly, I think. I get all the gas and I send it to ditch water and to the big island, to Cape Trelawney, to Crown Falls. And that's about it. I'm actually curious if after constructing the scholar, the research center, you can actually move gas pumps also. Now, it should be like an oil deposit though, so you should be able to move them, but I don't know if they included that in the research. Let's hope they did. Yeah. So overall, okay, my world is in a good place right now. These two tend to scrap with each other, you can see. And yeah, Smith doesn't like Kasparov, Kasparov doesn't like Smith, but Smith was allied with Bente and now they are both at war with Kasparov. And this is going on since the beginning of the game, basically. Yeah, so I choose not to get involved into their business. But I also need to be careful not to accept Bente's proposals for alliance that she gives every 5 minutes, which is still annoying. Okay. Now, we should hear something about them soon. Yeah, so the story is interesting. Look, they are almost there. Okay, not any time now. Any time now.
What a jolly, jolly surprise.
Time now. So after the first event, we will start preparing for some ships to send to the new region as soon as we find them. Okay. Come on, man. You can do it. You can do it. In fact, let's start now. So as I said, I don't know if it's unprocessed cotton or just cotton. Let's send you to the new world. A new thing they added, it was requested since the first month the game released. Yeah, you can now pick your island when you send a ship there. What's this? You're getting repaired? Or what? What are you showing me over repairing damage? Okay, repair your damage. This is an expedition ship. I keep them all around here. This I want actually to send to Enbesa. Let's buy an extravaganza steamer. Let's buy two. I can actually build them, but it's faster to buy them. Okay, let's keep them over here. So what I remember that I saw about production lines, I know the elders require glasses. Yes, I will deal with that after Enbesa. Require glasses, require cotton for one of their clothing types. They require, what do they require? Cotton, glass for their lamps. They also have lamps like in the Arctics, but they need different materials for those. They have oil lamps over there also. Okay. The scholars are all from Africa, so that's how it was. And they require gramophones. That's the information I succeed to remember. So that's about it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna build them. No. I think though. Thank you. I will construct something out of that. I think I will build a research center over here though, because we have a ton of I used to have 900, but yeah, there are some problems. Oh, something doesn't work right. I should have a ton of them. Yeah, I'll need to take care of that in between the events. Alright. So, the thing is, you can go everywhere in every port, not like in the Arctic thing, where you could only take one side, and then if you wanted to play, you had to replay it to get the other options. Over here you can go at every location that you discover. Okay, so let's go to Olispa first, then go to Al Souk and so on. Okay, I think this is Morocco. I don't remember which islands are these. These are roughly based on a real Mediterranean map. Okay, and actually don't remember these islands. I think they are owned by Spain, but I forgot the names. They should be a bit over here, I think, right? I Yeah, this is certainly Crete. And this, I don't know. I don't wanna say. Might be Malta. But it might also be another island that's closer to Spain. I don't actually know. Okay, let's go. A streetcar named Olispo. The lights of Olispo glimmer through the spray as your sailor hasten to secure their mooring. Yeah, as I said, I'm only reading the bolden text, but I'll give you time to read everything. So, last time I picked this. Yes, and he takes us to a small pub where we can get nothing very cool out of. They were trying to sell me sausages and other crap like that. Basically food. So let's pick this one though. Let's see what this one is, even though... Yeah. The Empire, eh? It is fortunate you have come this way, for we are not by nature a forgiving people, and there is much history between us. Yeah, he salutes us by using Portuguese words. Boa noite. I think it's Portuguese. For we are not by nature a forgiving people, and there is much history. Most of this written in blood. Indeed, indeed. Okay, we feast and revel tonight. We look to the future. I actually didn't read that one. Didn't play through this one, as I said. Hopefully the world changes. Why not? I'd imagine a tram here. I don't know if it appears genuine, but you cannot help but wonder how deeply these past grievances are truly buried. Let the strife of our parents die with them, then to your good health. War is the province of kings, and we will not be pawns in their games. Only... When Olispo has answered for its crimes, we will have peace. I actually don't know which island they are referred to. Yeah. Yeah. What should we take? I'm sure we will get in trouble, but let's just go. So this one is out of the question. We can actually get out and save if we want to experience everything, but we will just stick to one. Okay. Yeah. First stop. Okay. We have to wait a bit. They changed a bit. It saves. It takes a lot of time. Right. Let's continue. Alright. I wonder this or this. Let's take this and see what happened, but I think he wants to get us somewhere to murder us. Let's just go. Let's just go. Oh. Yeah, I was sure he doesn't care. Well, his king is royalist. Okay. Try to... then keeps this up. Okay. Royalists. Continue your journey. That's it. Let's take the other option then and see. Let's see. It will take a while because it takes a lot of time to load. Probably not edit this, because I have so much stuff to do, so skip ahead when you see loading and stuff. Come on, they added new art, they said they added it in the patch notes. They made some changes to the trade routes, but I haven't gotten the time to look at them yet. I'm thirsty, man. Yeah, probably we won't be loading that much. Only for this one, because I didn't explore this this part of the event. The one where you are telling the truth. And yeah. But for the others, I actually know what I want to pick and I'll go the same route. Let's see. So let's try this side. Let the strife of our parents die with them. Yeah. I think nothing good will come out of this. Oh, really? That's the good thing. Okay. Beaming smile lights up his face. To a better world and a bitter sweet promise of peace, let not our... No, it's not good. I don't think so. Gladly, we will get killed. Okay, Alexios takes your eager crew through the streets of Olispo. Oh, it's the same taberna. Yeah, you can get here if you die. But yeah. You can actually, if you pick the lying bit, you go to the tavern and then you are allowed to jump in the tramway basically, and go to a store and get an item. But I remember it was a green item and I had it, I think, so it was nothing special. But yeah, let's go to Alsuk. Now let's get this guy some fur clothes. So I have more fur clothes than I need, but somehow they consumed this faster than they were receiving it. Let me check. Sorry about that. The soda. We have a good ship sitting around. You, sir, where are you? Over here, go and get some fur coats, though. Go and get some fur coats. If they don't change the offer. Also, I want to see something. They changed and picked the way the offers are being made. You can see they added another row of items, so it's actually easier to get something that you want. Oh, and they switch up. This wasn't here. No, it was, but it didn't have a timer. And now, if you own Enbesa, this is the new rule, because they don't want you to buy off items and donate them to research. Okay. They're there on that guy. Called it cheating. Yeah, so for this one, in generally when I make Anno 1800 videos, there are times when I get hit with copyright notifications. All the time it's for the music. But for this one I will just leave the vids on. For the Enbesa part, I mean. I will just leave the vids on and whatever it is. Okay, where is the... Oh, over here. Yeah, I said we will go on fast, but I need to solve that though. Because we are building on that island and we want stuff to be available over here, okay? Something wrong with the trade route, I think, but I don't have time to check anymore. So I just have to correct this now. You, sir. Light bulbs. I think we have light bulbs. No. We should have a metric ton. Okay. Mm-hmm. This I don't really. I don't provide for them, but the rest is overflowing. And this is low over here because I take the most of it in the other part of the world. Your ship has returned from its voyage. Okay. This one we send here in case we need cotton, and I will keep it here until we reach Enbesa or until we actually need the cotton. Okay, now let's take care of the expedition. Uncertain shores. Palm-flanked arabesque. You dock at a small lively port on the northern coast. I will let you be... I'll give you time to read. Actually, I'm going to read that with my inner voice. Souk seems to be a... I don't know, a market of some sort, a bazaar. Mm-hmm. Several young men in beggarly clothes offer to guide them through the maze. Shoot them off. I didn't try this. I tried this and I think it was good. Okay. Oh, yes, I tried this and you get a reward, you get Professor Razik to the end of the... I think the rewards are fixed. So let's try this one now. Let's try this one. So they see one of them is cultured and they try to get him aboard. And you get Professor Razik after you complete this side of the... Let's see this one. It takes some observation, but your sailors soon understand that the mosaic of low-hanging clothes are arranged in specific patterns. This one I'll read because I don't know. A sharp right after a spice dealer's enthusiastic attempt to sell your crew a few years worth of ochre and red powders leads them to a small shadowed plaza where two musicians are strumming many string zithers of rich honeyed wood. There is a peacefulness to this place that suits your crew, and they try to engage the musician in conversation to learn more about their culture. Yeah, let's get a proper attempt to help them in their native language. Your crew's linguistic efforts attract much appreciative surprise. Appreciation, man, I can't say. Okay, I can't. I just give it up. and a lively conversation soon sparks up, supplemented by voluminous approximative sign language and much laughter. For your sailors can object an intricate tea set is brought out. Yes, they do want tea. They do like tea over there. And the small pewter cups, I do have something like that, are soon brimming with steaming crisp-scented mint tea. I do like this. Wow. I think mint tea is the best tea ever. I know the green tea is good for your health, but the mint tea for me is excellent. Supplemented by flavorsome pastries. Many tales are traded and nightfall has long since passed when your crew return to the ship, arms laden with simple but intricate tokens of friendship. No problem, guys. No problem, I refused Professor Razik because I have a ton of them also in the old world, so it's okay. Yeah, we are going to the ancient labyrinth. Let's go. Now let's I think for some of the let me just check. So I think for some portions of that event the game just stops or slows down considerably, but for some portions it doesn't. You can see this one should have been over here if no pause was involved, okay, because we spent some time in that event. In fact, I do want to send some warships. I feel like there will be conflict. I know there is a conflict because I played. A renowned personage has arrived. No need. Because I played through the trip, so there was some conflict during the expedition, but I suspect there is also armed conflict in that region. Okay. Yeah, we need more. All right. Okay. So I'll just focus on the Enbesa thing and the research center. Where would we? Don't want to move them around. I would just want to find the spot and just leave them there. Should we pick an island? So I know a scholar house can receive 120 students, so they don't need that much space, but we might need many houses though, so I don't know. I was tempted to make here a city for engineers and for scholars also to make this research island. Yeah, over here I have a ton of items that that reduce the necessary work. Let me show you. Yeah, the workforce. Actually, I think over this, how many do we need? Zero. Yes, so these are working by themselves, but the route for delivering oil is not efficient, even though this should be enough for what I have built. Okay, now let's take care of the other thing. Yeah, so I'm only using fast for this one, for the trip duration. I will play on normal speed after that, okay? So maybe some of you know the legend, how the Minotaur has come to be. I won't repeat it for you. So somebody fell, okay, or somehow is locked in the, let me just turn the sound a bit off, somehow it got locked in the ancient labyrinth. So alone in the darkness, they cannot hear her cries. Deep beneath this pleasant island of lavender and thyme, she has fallen to a musty, airless pit. She gathers herself and remembers the few safety matches left in her pack. You are her. We are her. She is you. Lighting a match, you are dumbstruck by a many fresco room. Venerable, appreciative. God damn it, guys. Okay. Venerable and forgotten. A woman with a bowl is the centerpiece. The great beast seems so vulnerable under her caress. The outline of a majestic horned door faces north, while a more humble passage heads southward. Yes, I just wanted to fight a Minotaur and I picked this. Yeah. Okay, an opening in the ground is slowly drawing in sludgy water from all parts. A fountain, perhaps? A ship dominates a large fresco, and I only wonder if it ever managed to return from its voyage unscathed. Hey. A large door with a familiar pattern open to the south. That means it's the same pattern. Okay, you turn to face it when you notice a second smaller door to the west. A soft hiss, the wind perhaps seems to be coming from it. Yes, so I picked south because I thought it would lead to the Minotaur, but this place seems strangely familiar because we got back where we were. So now I'm picking the humble passage. Even though I didn't pick the Grand Hordor, Humble Passage, okay, so that part I didn't pick. But this one leads us to a reward, so I'm going to pick that again. We're in the... Okay, this I didn't see. I didn't click on it. I didn't go this way, guys. I didn't go this way. I picked the big horned gate and then I picked a small humble door. Now I remember. Now I don't know what this is about. Damn. In the next chamber you find a set of stone shelves with fragments of wooden figures upon them. Men, horses and bulls. Toys perhaps. A distant growl rumbles across the walls, stirring dust from a pale fresco. Facing east, a swan door. Facing north, flocks of herons make up a labyrinthine mosaic surrounding a pillared arch. I don't know what's a swan door, but let's go to the labyrinth, guys. Is it this Icarus? Mind-bogglingly complex mazes are etched in dark blue over every tile, on the walls, floor and ceilings. In the center, a lone figure stands minuscule amidst the labyrinthine landscape. The fresco in this room, the picks a lame metalsmith. Just then you notice something cold lapping at your feet, water briny and pale. It seems to be seeping in from a room not far off, facing west. Oh, we can let's do this. I don't know if we are allowed to go back here again. Let's go to the swan door. What is this? Oh, yeah. This is the legend, I think. In here, the ceiling feels lower still. Chipped tiles of the on the floor hint at a faded scene. A man, youngish and light, leaping over a flaring ball. You lean in for a closer look and notice all the tiles in the room are adorned with balls' heads. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, so I guess the reward that I had was a simple minotaur-shaped cup. So the good stuff is still over here. How much? Let's take the higher chance though, right? Leap over the... You leap over the tiles effortlessly and smirk at the figure in the fresco, challenging him to do better. Did you hear that? You notice a second fresco, bolder and duskier. Oh, you edged over two stairwells, one of them bears west and the other east. The fresco depicts a young woman passing a ball of thread to a young man. Who might that be? As you ponder your choices, a deep, low rumble echoes from the depths. Oh yes, and this takes, this takes me to the same reward, I guess, because I remember, maybe I'm wrong though. Let's descend the uneven steps. Yeah, I remember now. You might get the same reward doing some different choices though. I guess they want us to get that reward. A gaping chasm stares at you where the floor has collapsed into a distant cave far below. A smoke-tarred beam, narrow and edged, stretches over the pit to the other side. Yeah, so I took this route and we fell off and we found the reward. Let's try crouch and crawl. So my logic was that if you crouch and crawl along the beam, the bean has to support your entire weight and it will break for sure. Just running fast over it, you should have a chance to reach the other spot in real life. But in this one, you just fell by taking this. So let's go over here. You kneel down on the edge of the beam and crawl painfully across its dark, narrow surface. There is the slightest of creaks before the beam gives way, rotten and broken by edges, and you fell into the darkness. The tumble is shorter than expected and you promptly find yourself in the same spot okay, yeah. Bloodied and bruised, but alive, facing a tall door, chestnut wood have faded, supports an alarmingly lifelike carving of a bull's head. Cavernous rumbling, or is it growling, seeps in from behind the door. Yes, I am brave like that, so let's open the door. Number one. Darkness there and nothing more. Footsteps echo against a distant vaulted ceiling. You reach for light and find one match left. One match and then darkness. So actually I advanced without light. Okay. Let's see what happens if you strike your last match. Let's get out and save. They allow you to do that. Last match. Match? Is this how you say match? Okay, let's wait for this cogwheel to finish turning. Okay. So yes, it seems that your choices lead you to the same thing. no matter what branch you would take, but sometimes they just give you the exit, you know. I mean that the event stops and you don't get anything, as you could see over there when that guy got upset because we talked about the king, everything but the king. Okay. Oh. Okay, we know about this. A dusty ochre light reveals a wide room with ornate frescoed wall, the most striking of which is a contest between a hero and a beast, half man, half bull. Your eyes widen, a sudden growl surges into a roar behind you. Wow, cool. You swivel to face it, but a powerful breath smothers the feeble flame at your fingertip. You have just enough time to distinguish the flared nostrils and sharp horns of a colossal bull before the darkness swallows you. Flee? No, because he can hear you. Stand absolutely still. It's the same reward. Yeah, it's the same reward. You hold your breath, not daring to make a sound. Silence seeps through the shadows. After an eternity, you dare to stretch out your hand and feel for the beast. Your fingers find cold stone, tracing a jawline, then an eye, a statue, lifelike to a fault, and one of the finest craftsmanship. You discover that the brackish warm air gushing in from a hidden aperture in the wall on which is set, it's being amplified ingeniously by the marmoreal beast's mouth. A momentous discovery, an entire civilization, a hidden culture, a forsaken sanctuary, an epic for the ages. Thrilled, you reach behind the creature's neck to a glimmer of light and pry open the brittle wall to emerge into the fresh air of today. It's the same reward. It seems it's only one reward. I wonder. Yeah, that means the reward we could have gotten from the bazaar, it was the same in the first stop we did. Yeah, they are fixed and they are leading you to the reward, but you can actually fail and just get out of the event also. So it's a glass in the form of a bullhead, basically. Ritual drinking vessel found in an ancient labyrinth carved from a single block of black steatite. Accept. Let's drop those and move on. Actually, let me think. Because now. Yeah, let's go, it's okay, continue your journey. You don't have any other options over here. We're going to the Nile right now. Okay, -8. Anyway, we have enough. And at some point we gain some morale back. Alright. Let's hurry this. Yeah, so I was thinking to get it over here, and I was saying that the route is not very efficient, even though we have enough oil, because it's too far from the port. Yeah. So another option, what would the another option be? I guess I could have built that port over here, but still, it would have, so it's not efficient, the route is not efficient. I tried to arrange the rails in order to get at all times, but still, for the most times, it works. Just not now. I'll have to take a look at it. And I wanted to make this an engineer heaven, even before I knew what Enbesa was about. And now I'm thinking I would add the scholars here also. Yeah. But probably you won't see that, because that will take a few hours. But we are going to focus on the Enbesa story for a bit. At least for the main story, okay? Don't think I'm going to take quests, side quests from there, though. So, they did it in a different way with this DLC. Actually, you get King Ketema, which is the leader over there. He's trying to unify the lands. He wants to go into the industrial age. Stuff like that, as far as I could understand. And he has the palace on your main island, which you have to develop for him. Now, I think they won't be relieving me from that island after I built it up. That would be cruel, guys, that would be cruel. Okay, let's just sit pretty and wait a bit. I think... Yeah. Yeah, I have to make a decision, because... You can't move monuments between the islands, so the research center is a monument and I don't want to build it a second time. Maybe we should just build it over here somewhere and just leave artisans, engineers and investors on this island and move the lower tiers to another island close by and just use those ships to get the workforce in. We can afford it. Yeah, I think that's the best thing we can do. Mm-hmm. That's what we are going to do, but now I just would like to decide where to build it. So I don't move them that far. Okay, next event. Tomb Raiders! I'm not gonna read the entire thing. I only read the things that I didn't see in my first playthrough, okay? So you are alone seeking the fabled lost necropolis. Yeah. Basically, you find a guy who's a young woman. And she needs your help to find something, yeah, and needs a responsible person to help the local museum recover it. I just went this part and actually gotten something, but I forgot what. Yeah, it was a couple of statues. Okay, this means the event is over. This I don't know how, but we don't have hunting, so let's pick this. Maybe I should save. Doesn't matter, I don't take this. The story doesn't end over here, okay? Alright. Yeah. So I'll give you a time to read this, because I don't want to prolong this part as too much anymore. It's still long, so we need to find where the trail begins for the thing that she wants to recover. Yeah, this is actually a common item. It's available at the prison guy, at Eli, so we don't need to take it. Okay, and I took this one because it's basically, it doesn't fail. Hardly a challenge for a seasoned navigator. Okay, so they do find it. I did this, take a leap of faith into the water. It's a nod to Assassin's Creed, of course. A leap from there, that would be madness. Yeah, take a leap. Yes. You nimbly climb the burning rock. Yeah, your fate is rewarded. You find yourself in a shallow chamber painted with a once beautiful depiction. A humble reed raft carrying the sun out of the rippling waters and into the star-dotted sky. Two dark passageways lead further into the stone. So I'm gonna take all the choices that I did because they will lead to the reward, okay? So I took this one. The raft dives into the water beside the left door just as you dove to get here. Terminal galleries wind across and over each other. At the center of it all, casting a shadowy pall over the city, stands a mausoleum of godly proportions. Atop the grim entrance, several ominous signs are carved. I did ignore the warning, and the second is abandon the necropolis and just go home. We are not here to go home. It's go big or go home. Ignore the warning. A long passage slopes down into the earth. Ornate paintings must once have covered every inch of the walls, but now only indecipherable lines and constellations survive. Okay, two lower passages head east and west into the darkness below a set of arches covered in symbols. I took this one, but I think we can get, I don't know, we can get the same reward as it seems. Let's take this, because you have to go inside, you don't have to get outside, you know? She was but a few paces ahead of you, but all of a sudden the scholar has vanished. Perhaps something awful befell her, or perhaps this is indeed a correct path and she no longer has use of you. Yes, that's the truth. As you look around, a strange and distant howling startles you. A hidden door is very slightly ajar, betrayed by the wind over its threshold. Should I save? Actually, we passed the trial last time when I didn't save. Now let's just, I don't know, let's hope. Let's click it. A long silence fills the chamber as your torch softly sputters out. The darkness comes quickly and then the sound of softly lapping water near your feet, several somethings weave silkily between your toes, unseen monsters talking, say, oh my god, sensing, lurking, you mutter in breathless prayer, unexpectedly, perhaps your humility, your calm has a positive effect. As uncannily as it came, the water seeps away, taking the strange entities with it. The path ahead is clear. Forge ahead. I will read this, okay? Just to give you context, in case you are too lazy to read, okay? A high chamber. Stretches into the darkness around a basalt pyramid. At the pyramid's bone white crown is a pedestal bearing the fabled statue of Hor. It's actually Horus, but they do like to change the names in the game, you know? Standing before it is the historian. She seems entranced, Her fingers inches from the statue's exquisite golden lips, her mutterings echo strangely. At last they will know how great I am. Such opportunities by selling it, never want for anything again. Something draws your attention at the foot of the pyramid, slithering there, a patch of restless and unworldly darkness. The historian's hand reaches out towards the statue. So I had the hunch that there was a trap over there. And I picked this. It's her prize, now turn away. Okay, actually I don't have the guts to pick this, because... Yeah, and it's the same statue. Okay. It's part of a new set, Gods of the Delta. I assume it has a 3D... 3D model when you add it into the museum. Grim whispers echo strangely from the shadowy confines of the chamber. A swirly, glowing sensation almost knocks you over as something wakes. The historian's mutterings grow louder, definitely louder, painfully louder. A resounding crack follows as if bones were shattered. Then silence. When your eyes open, the chamber is empty. The light from your torches flickers dully on the statue. Sand, great pyramids of bleak sand, pile high against the chamber walls. The historian is nowhere to be seen. Deciding it's best not to linger, you wrap the statue carefully and respectfully before retreating gleefully out of the necropolis. And that's the third event. Third or fourth? It's the fourth event. Okay, let's see what we drop. We might still need this, so we have to drop the champagne. That means, but I think we got enough morale to go through the entire expedition though. Last time I had champagne and cigars, so I could drop some of them, and I only had three important people on the ship. But we will do just fine. I think we are getting a legendary. So, let me see. Navigation, crafting. Navigation. Yeah, I think I will have to drop the carriages. Next. Okay, go. Okay, see, we got back some of the morale, but now we are losing it because, yeah. Alright, let's go over here. Continue the expedition. How can I return home? Even though theoretically you could keep the rewards. I don't think you can try them again in the other expedition. I never tried to fail the expedition though. Alright, so I'm thinking over here. Even though I would like to have them here. So theoretically, they need I do have engineer workforce available, because I forgot I built all those all of these, the commuter piece. Yes, okay, we are building here the research center. Doesn't need to be in the middle of the town over here. Yeah, we are building it on this island. That's what we are doing. Okay, let's keep it a bit on slow and add some resources over here. building construction materials. So we need a ton of windows. We do have steel. We do have reinforced concrete. I assume we'll need basic resources also, like like raw concrete or whatever it's called in this one. But let's be prepared with main things. Okay, what do we have over here though? I wanna see how much we have. 600. Why do I have sleeping bags over here? So 600, I can still. Yeah, but I don't want to. I do not want that. No. Okay, 600 is enough. Okay, so that means we can get 500 concrete and let's say 450 windows. Come on, guy. Let's get like this. Let's get like this. Let's send it. Do I have a pier over here? Okay, I do have piers over here, so it's okay. While we wait for the second event, let's do that. Yes, I'm gonna build the entire thing over here. Yeah, they don't like the pollution though, the engineers and probably the scholars also, but it's a lot of empty space. And we can have a science town over here. Also, I know the scholars need a radio station, but only at 7,000 scholars. And what else do they need? They need university because they are basically students involved in research. And that's about all I know. They do have some stuff that needs to be produced in Enbesa and sent to them, like that soup they like, something based on fish and stuff like that, and also some clothing, but we'll have to see. I don't know all the details. Yeah, but I probably won't bore you through everything of that. I'll just stick to the story as much as I can. Come on, guy. Yeah, we can do it. This ship is slower than the others, but it will go places if required. Man, it's I'm surprised that I'm not bored, okay, because as I said, I played through this part again, and because OBS did pull some things on me, let's just take this out. Yeah, I could I think I actually have set up something for putting supplies, but okay, and one more trip. Yeah, let's send her and we'll take care of it after the event. The Kulisma canal, it's actually that canal that is between Africa. Okay, that allowed us to shorten the way towards the Indies. I don't know how to say that name in English though. So the explosion scattered debris across the canal. as your helmsman carefully steers into the nascent Kulisma Canal. A deafening blast ahead of you sends most of your crew sprawling across the deck. The initial shock overcome, they rush to their station and pull the ship into a crawl, bringing it to rest mere feet away from the listing, flame-wrecked carcass of a ship. Wrecked or wrecked? Doubtless it will be days before all is cleansed and navigation can resume. One of your sailors furrows their brow. Any thought that there ain't no one in the water? Odd indeed. In fact, there's no trace at all of the exploded ship's crew, and a irresistible mystery. Yeah, so I took this. We got all we had to do from this. Request ship records from the canal authorities. It takes some persuasions, but you convince the officials to let you look into the cargo report for the ship. It reads FS Dufresne from Akiana cleared. I don't know how to. Crossing this day. Upholstery and tools. Noted. Nothing salient, yet something feels off, and your sailor quickly remembers FS is not an imperial prefix. Then why register the ship as foreign? Slowly they just changed the other name and they didn't cover the FS probably. Slowly it dawns up upon you, assuming this is no mistake, does it not imply deliberate sabotage by your own countrymen? It may have implications for the crown if you were to inform the locals. So actually took this and it was just continuing the route, okay, with her their tanks. I'm actually curious to what this is. Let's see what this is. Fortunately, only a few members of the crew heard the ghastly secret. All of them are immediately pledged to silence for queen and country. When their duties have been resumed, your captain sends a carefully worded epistle to Sir Archibald Blake, assuring him of the crew's loyalty and abnegation in removing any evidence. Surely the queen will reward such loyal subjects. Yeah, so there is no reward over here, it seems. We're just passing through. Okay. Go to the Holy City. Actually, don't remember what we got from that spot. Okay. Yeah, so see, there is a break of some sort when you are checking events. Nice. I don't think this was in. I don't remember that being in. I know the game kept going around you. The smoke is too long. There are some. I don't know how the recording will be, but There seems to be some stuttering in this view. Alright. Let's get 150 more. I think it will fit over there, right? 50 of each, 150 of each.
New orders.
Oh, by the way, now you can actually change this for every island separately, just in case you have production islands like me. So in this case I produce scabs and waters, because I forgot actually.
We've reached capacity.
And filaments and the bulb making business is over here. For now, I don't know. I think I'll leave it over here because it's quite efficient over here around this trade union. They have electricity. You see, I'm overproducing, so I still have some legendary people which give a ton of bonuses, but I haven't gotten around to look at them and put them in the right places. Let's go for the next event. Actually forgot what you get from this place. Are you here on pilgrimage? Actually saw this and I forgot what I get. Let's go through this. There is a bound of a city sacred to all in this land. And a holy pilgrimage that must be undertaken. Yes, we know what this is about. Are you here on pilgrimage? No. He walks up to your crew, carefully examining each man and woman. Any faithful who would undergo the pilgrimage will be under our protection, as the Wadi is a land of... Okay, and the lambs of the war machine. Okay. Unbelievers are not normally invited to join the caravans, but perhaps if you were to contribute to pilgrims' funds... There is no mistaking the very secular thirst in his gaze as he eyes your purse. Turn away, fainting in comprehension. Comply with a bribe to ensure your crew's safety. I will not bribe you, sir. No. No. Let's see where this goes, because we have some skills though. The man thrusts an arm out, grabbing a sailor by the collar and throwing them to the ground. Do not hear me, unbelievers. By law, you must pay a tribute. Choose swiftly whether it be of blood or coin. He draws a short, wickedly bladed sword, and to your alarm, several other guards nearby raise their rifle, aiming straight at your crew. Surrender some of your possession. No. Attempt to surprise your foes. A burly fellow jumps to his feet, hurling his heavy pack at the surprised guards, while a young woman darts at the lead officer, leaning under the hasty blow to seize the curved dagger at his belt, knocking her foe down with a crashing pommel blow to the temple. Yes, that would be bad, no matter how strong you are. His companion's eye widen just long enough for several of your gunsmiths to dive at them, sending them crashing to the soil before being deftly disarmed. The sense of victory is however fleeting, as you now have little choice but to flee this land. Okay, no problem, guys. No problem. Yeah. Go to the savannah. And after that we will reach Enbesa. Actually don't remember what I got from this place, but it wasn't. It wasn't something spectacular, if I remember correct. Man, no, it was, man. Oh. No, no, there is another event where you get a legendary. Let's keep continue. Let's keep continuing. Let's keep continuing. I am tired of it, but still, I'm having fun. Alright, guy. Did you? Okay, now he arrived. So I actually don't understand when they stop and when they move, because it's weird for me. So last time he was only at half of the route and we spent some time in the event, but now he just arrived here. So the research center is a monument. Now I don't know what you need for it, but usually you need some cement and I don't know if I'm producing it over here though.
We can't shut the storeroom door.
Yeah. What? Oh, we do have. That means we have tons. Where would that be? At raw materials. Okay, we do have. Let's get some cement. What would they need? They would need bricks because the building looks like it's in the same style as the... Where do we have it? As this. So I probably will need some cement. God damn it, man, I don't know how to speak anymore. Okay. Oh, really? Let's put a break on it. So cement and what else? Glasses, we have windows, maybe some steam motors, but I'm not actually sure. Steam motors might be, but we have those over here also. We'll see, we'll just have to wait and see. Yeah, so last time I took this option. And the chances were too low to catch lions, so I had to go with my hands empty from this place. I'm giving you time to read this, because I'm not tormenting your ears anymore. I decided this. Just with the last event, I'm going to read it. Okay, so let's take the head to the waterhole. Your party edges stealthily through the high grass towards the hidden waterhole. Because I didn't do this, I will read it. As they reach a ledge where soft soil has fallen into the muddy water below, they gasp in wonder at the teeming life gathered there. Scores of creatures huddle by the water, tall-necked giraffes spread their legs awkwardly. Yes, they do. To lean down and lap the surface, while nervous meerkats and contemptuous gnus eye the water so worriedly. And with the suspicious profile of those drifting logs, it's not without reason. Suddenly the ground shakes. You will about to see a manifestly infuriated rhinoceros charging at your cop. Come on, guys, we just got here. Dodge the charge. You can't stay still and silent with those beasts running around. Climb up nearby trees. Years of seamanship. Climbing the rigging of a moving storm-tossed ship makes scaling low twisted trees only a minor challenge. The rhinoceros... What? Oh, I thought they said the rhinoceros have trumps. Oh my god, man. Rhinoceros trumps to a halt when it realizes its quarry. Quarry has vanished, looking around with dull, red-shot eyes before retreating into the sun-worn high grass. As the sailors ease down from their hiding places, they dejectedly realize that the creatures... Oh my god, guys. Tony Trua's charge has chased all the animals from the waterhole. And there is not left to do but retreat back to the camp. So yeah, this is a fail event. Taking the other side, climbing those spurs, as they refer to, takes you in the company of a pride of lions. And if you have enough hunting skills, maybe you can capture a lion. But I don't have any hunting specialists over here. So we did get nothing, like last time. But over here, we get a legendary item. Alright, for the museum. Not that. Okay, so let's do this. We still have enough morale, I would say, to reach it. Alright. So, I assume we will need cement and what else? Maybe steam motors, but I'm not sure. A research center. What would a research center need? Dynamite, because they like experimenting with stuff. We'll see. What's this? Okay. Yes. Yes. And yes. Okay, let's hurry it up and I'm tired. I think I'm going to bed after this. I just don't have the stamina to stay up one night just to experience the new DLC. I just can't do it anymore, guys. If I would have just checked OBS before I started recording the first run through the expedition, yeah, maybe now I'd be building in Enbesa, but yeah, after this I'll probably call it a night. Come on, guys. So come on, you can do it. You can do it. Let's move you back over there. Wait. Actually, I have an idea. Let's slow a bit down. Let's move to the... Okay. I wanted to prepare this to keep them over there. I assume these two are enough. I do plan to make some in-session trading. I assume we have trading partners over there. This one I don't want to send, but this one I will. This one is keeping preparing itself for what reason I don't know. Oh, thank you very much, guys. So I waited for this one for a long time because yeah, he doesn't use, if you use him you can make glasses without brass, So when I stopped playing, I was in the process of converting the glass production to use lumber, but I still need to build over there a big lumber production, and I do have the items. Just as I said, I delayed the whole thing for Land of Lions, but this one just appeared for me in, I actually screenshotted that at around 150 hours in this game, something like that. Okay. Yeah, let's get you out of this spot, okay, because you are bothering us. We don't have this one anymore. Let's keep. Soon, I promise. Now I'll. This is a steamship. Let's take this because I'm not sure about the military over there. Yeah, let's get this for this one. Actually, no, this one is actually better. And this one is even better because it gives straight prices also. Yeah. Okay, let's do it like this. You sir, so this is an upgrade for this one, right? Also, it's an upgrade for both of these two. Let's get this, let's drop this, let's get this, and let's keep them over here. Yeah, now I have a few. In fact, I have a ton of ships that are standing around, so I think I'm gonna take these two. Let's get them closer to the edge of the map, just so they can arrive faster in Enbesa when I need them. These guys I'm going to keep here and see if I require stuff from the old world that I don't know about. Alright. Now let's take care over the next event. The last tale of the Tanetier. I have no idea. Jernet might be an anagram, but I'm too tired to try to solve it. One of the lower halyards suddenly snaps. Problem. Ship broken. Or perhaps something of their tail. Okay, I'm gonna give you time to read it. Alright. So they are shipwrecked. Basically, the ship is not gone yet, but it's broken a bit. And perhaps something of their tail. Of the long forgotten vessels that. Shipwrecked over here may yet be found on the strangest of islands. Explore the plains. The trees here stretching through tortuous shapes. Okay. I will read the last thing. When a woman points out the silhouette of distant houses on a mountainous plateau. Actually, we can do both of them. I think I took this one because it has the higher chance, but they do tend to go to the same spot, I think. Okay, lizards large enough to fill a bucket unblinkingly. Follow your crew's progress to the bar, to the brush. And the dim light reveals a vast underground chamber. Oddly, there are several antique and broken crates scattered in a corner. Yeah. Explore the maze in search of an exit. Yeah, so I think yeah, wisely suggesting we are in a maze, we want to get out. All right. Yeah, but we do want to study the ruins. Oh, sorry, I'm done. Tokens abandoned by past visitors abound in the many alcoves hollowed out of the city's cavern walls. Silver eagles, worn green by time. Join Argid. I don't know how to spell that. Argid stars with missing rays in the silent village. Surrounded by crests and copper coins that trace the bloodlines of strange kings. Everywhere the relics of a storied past professed the island's position as a place of trade, perhaps pilgrimage, yet no tokens of recent centuries seem present among the horde. I played Total War and there is an island that had a gold mine over there. I just forgot how it was. You were tasked to conquer it. I forgot what the name was. I think that's the island. A man shouts suddenly. A dense wall of tasseled prickly shrubs has mysteriously parted, unveiling a narrow path along the cliffside to a village on the mountain's peak. So we wouldn't get through all of this if we would have chosen to climb the mountain. Probably. Find the town's seat of power. The path winds ever steeper through the smattering of houses to the summit of the hill, where a bent shrine, I will read this entirely, a bent shrine etched with faded figures of abandoned gods sits beside a deep well. A low stone vault leading into the cliff hides a store of rare essences. I don't know how to read all of them. Ghee, frankincense, myrrh, santal, and cinnamon. Ghee, I never heard of ghee. With careful wax seals preserving the hallowed contents, making it a valuable trove for antiquity dealers. A low sturdy palace sits on the edge, most spore resolutely intact despite years of neglect. It can be intact and neglected at the same time, as it's nothing stands that well. Okay, to the test of time. As the party reaches for the door, a sudden howl of wind breaks the cool silence. Unexpected thunderstorm surges up from the valley below, hurling rain and tempest upon the unwary company. Yes, so I took shelter in the regal building and you get a legendary museum artifact if you pick the right answers. Yes, I went for the truth, because I don't know, this guy seemed like something special. Okay, and I didn't wanna try to lie to him, even though it shows as success. The corroded hinges need to be excised from the frame before it can easily be prized open, and the company slip into the dusky hall, glad to escape the swelling tempest. There is an air of rustic elegance to the faded red walls, patterned with white chalk. A low secretary of rich chocolate wood holds a wealth of parchment, old and new. Who is it that comes unheeded to these halls? Comes a sudden and commanding voice. And what have you done to my door? A venerable man stands atop a nearby staircase, clad in a raiment of gold and turquoise. Have no idea who this guy is. Gold and turquoise. His long beard, that means multiple, braided with strands of netted gemstones. His hands rest on the railing for support, but such is the nobility of his bearing that your expedition find themselves bowing low to him. Truth. Fate stranded us and exploration brought us here. Big lion, an ancient artifact brought us to these shores. Okay, we got teleported. He smiles softly and he rewards us. Don't know what's this, man. I never heard of Tan, but they do like to change the names and yeah. Might be something related to the African continent, which I never heard about. Okay. So stand, you search the palace for him, but he has vanished. You will find many treasures and Astanetier sinks back into the fog. One man swears he saw gargantuan figure, it's a big snake, slither to rest around its shores, nesting the island in an embrace of gold and turquoise scales. So probably it's tied to a legend, to an African legend. And we get this. Now we have a problem. There is the last event and there is a conflict over there. So I remember we need firepower, but I just don't remember if we need force also. So I don't want to give out any of this, but we do have force. Yeah, let's say, let's drop the steam carriages. Okay, let's go. Whoa. Continue your journey. So we are almost Prelapasarian. What the hell is that? Lofty Prelapasarian. Sileamidos. Sodimaelis. Sodimaelis. It's probably something. But it's also tied to a legend of some sorts. Okay. Yeah, let's go. Soon this will be over and we'll reach Enbesa. And I'll go to sleep. Yeah, so tired, man. Let's hurry it a bit. Probably not edit this vid, so know what to do. And I'm so busy that I'll probably not add bookmarks in the vid, so you can skip to them also. It's just a half a minute how much it is between the events. A third, yeah. Third. Be honest, don't act so civilized. Can polish a third. A third. Yeah. Come on, guys. Come on. Just have one more performance to give. Yeah, a theatrical performance. I will read the last bit. I will torment you with that. Alright, alright. So if I stop, no. Nah. Let's go. Smoke on the waters. Ship astern, Captain. She's gaining on us. It's an attack. A powerful ship. Latines taut with dry wind. Ports gaping with expectant violence. Swivels out of a hidden nook past the heavily wooded coast. She's flying a flag of carmine and sable, emblazoned with a triumphant sun. Colors unknown to any of the crew, as she deftly weaves in and out of the waves, catching the draft masterfully to close the distance with great speed. A thunderous explosion rocks her port side. Something whistles through the air and plummets into the emerald waters behind your ship. You swing hard to port, breaking line as your gun ports creak open hurriedly and your deckhands take careful aim. Actually, I think it's the same. It's the same. Let's hope we do some stuff. A first volley crashes into the enemy side, then a second as the lower gun teams let loose. Fire leaps to claw at a gaping wound in the vessel's flank before its yards thunderstorm into two minuscule figures scuttle along its deck, struggling to smother the eager flames before a sudden and mighty explosion sends all those on deck sprawling and scrambling as the ship lists dangerously in the water. A burly man in what must be officer's attire billows over the din, his voice heavy with the tang of authority. He appears to be holding a young man at gunpoint. Mercenaries and murderers, trust Ketema to stoop to such methods. Silence your guns, or your friend here will taste lead. I tried this, that guy doesn't accept bribes. I know neither this man nor the Ketema of whom you speak. The man scoffs. A likely story. No sooner had your sails been sighted than he. The disgust in his voice is palpable. Warned us to release him, lest you rain Ketema's fury upon us. Yeah. A glance at the young man's frantic countenance is enough to understand that he had in fact been attempting to intimidate the rogues so as to extricate himself from these dire straits. As he sorely attempts to retain some semblance of self-control, his eyes plead for your men to play along. Yeah, I took this one. Why wouldn't he need help when you stand 40 against him? The man draws himself up with dignified fury. And where were such morals when your master sent his legions to drive families from their ancestral land so he could raise the mighty warehouses he takes such pride in? This man is a servant of oppression, a fiend. In a sudden flurry of movement, having sensed the captain's grip loosen, the young prisoner elbows him in the ribs and leaps into the sea before he can desist. Shoot the emissary if you must, splutters the red-faced captain, but when the young man fails to resurface, he realizes his bargaining chip is gone. He orders his gun to be turned. They are aiming for my crew. Wow. This one worked. But this one is cool also. Fire flaming shot at the ship's sails and stores. Let's see. Riflemen keep the enemy cowed under steady fire as the three-man crew of the hotshot furnace carefully prepare the deadly missiles. Taking advantage of the bracing winds, your captain motions the helmsman to move the enemy's stern within firing distance. A streak of red burns through the air, followed by several others as the projectiles crash into the enemy deck through men and debris alike, spreading broad swathes of fire that soon latch onto the surrounding crew and railings. Horrified cries echo through the rising smoke. Just jump in the water. Oh, I forgot. The seamen don't know how to swim. Yeah. Strangely muffled as the ship lists and lurches sideways into the ocean, its hull sundered and flaming. As your captain calls to set sail and leave the battlefield, a curious rasping is heard from the port side. Someone is climbing aboard. Yeah. Wait for the intruder to show himself. My god, guys, I'm glad I'm not the only one with English problems over here. It's one intruder, so you can't say themselves. You have to say himself. Well, see, I know a bit. Smoke on the waters. Hearing the dry click of rifles cocked and ready to fire, a voice protests from below the railing. Hold fire, I'm the man they were holding prisoner. After a moment's silence, a hand appears upon the railing, followed by the light figure of the young prisoner. Evidently disconcerted by the score of rifles aiming at him. Sorry for dragging you into this unfortunate situation. Those rogues sank my ship and slayed my crew, and I was desperate for any kind of help. As he says this, the crew lowers their rifles a little. I feared they wished to prize from me my lord's secrets and plans. When I saw your sails, it seemed my only reprieve, so I told them, Yani hoi ketema sencha. This is the king. We will meet him soon. Who were those poor ruffians? Warmongers and brutes in the service of the princes of Angereb. Angereb sounds like an Egyptian city. There was fighting over there. There was a lot of fighting over there in that area. Well, where in the world there wasn't any fighting for land and power, if we stay and think about it. Nothing, absolutely no place on earth is war virgin, okay? I'll say it metaphorically. A noble folk, but their refusal to honor the emperor has driven them to violent ends which I feel will only ever result in grief and pain. So I don't know if this stops over here, but I will send some warships in this session just for the duration of the the story. But why attack you? Of course, pardon my manners. I'm Biniam, son of Kyria, emissary of his imperial majesty Ketema. I'm on a mission to seek out experts from around the world to assist with the many ambitions my lord has for Enbesa. The emperor wishes for the name of Enbesa to be sung and admired for its learnedness, beauty, prosperity, and wisdom. But let us not tarry here. Come, follow me to Taborim, where my lord will be sure to reward your brave generosity. Set sail for the south past the, sorry, I'm almost sleeping right now, past the pillar drifts with ochre flowers, cross the marshes and then you will see it, ancient Enbesa with gold-lit mountains, slumbering lands and proud people. Alright, and now the cutscene follows. It might be, it is stuttery at some points, some of it might be too due to the OBS recording also, having some issues with OBS lately, but this is it, basically, we reached Enbesa.
Such noble hearts are ever welcome in Enbesa. So, you heard I was seeking for talents such as yours to expand our new capital.
Our meeting was serendipity alone, my emperor.
Then the Lord truly smiles on you. There is opportunity here to be part of a tale greater than all of us. So far, I have neglected this arid province of the Empire, seat of the kings of old. But from the dust, a garden will bloom anew. Many lives of kings has it been since last Enbesa, so united, frail as that legacy may hold. Some would see us divided, each to their own purpose. They are blind to the greater threat. Hungry eyes turning south towards us. In unison and with pride, we will return their stares.
So must all stand to defend their share.
So to you, I would entrust the raising of Taborim, our new capital, on these lands. May it grow unite all in Beza under one covenant. Young Binyam will help you settle, share his plan for the canals. Taborim may soon shine like a jewel of peace on the girdle of this great nation. I wish to speak with you on matters of great importance concerning all in Besa. Will you work with me to help my people?
So, if you don't approve, that means you won't be experiencing the quests. Okay, you won't experience the Enbesa storyline, just in case. Maybe you don't want to because you played your second playthrough and stuff like that, okay? But I think you get the quest islands though. Alright. So let's go. Just wanted to send those ships.
Attention for the Admiral.
Now, let's go to the island. What? Okay, I don't have an island yet. Let's go and talk to the king and then we'll stop. Which one would be this? 5.
Scepter of Covenant. Bid you
Scepter of Covenant. Okay, where? Okay.
Bring her around.
It's a big map. Let's take a look around where we go. So I notice sometimes this disappears. I don't know how to do that though. Let's take a look at the islands we discover. Linseed fertility, hibiscus fertility, death grass, lobster abundance. So I'm actually curious if you can take water from this island and bring it to another. I don't think you can though. I do not think you can. Yeah, so on this session you don't have mines, but you do have the water system and gold. Is it cold over here, man? Are they preparing anything else for us? Nah. Huh? Or they just lied to us so they don't spoil the DLC to us. It could be something. Is it grass or is it matter? I wonder. Is it dry grass over there or matter? Just have to see. Okay. Must say I don't really like this, seeing this dry grass over here. We must do something about it. So let's go. Yeah, we need an island. But we couldn't send anything, just directly to the session. Oh, I can.
How thrilling. A renowned person.
Let's keep these ships around here for a while. And then we'll I don't care right now. Let's go back. Seems to be a bit bigger. Seems to be a bit bigger than a medium map. Actually, I don't know if the AI will follow us over here. It might. They'll probably buy off the islands. I like the added lakes. Very cool. Indigo. Spice. Okay. I like the music also, it's... Yeah. This is a quest island, I understand your choices affect everything around here. Their look. I will try to keep everything, guys, so we'll see how it goes. There are three quest islands, each one is different, and probably we are going to have war over here though. Unsettled island. Man, this doesn't really feel like grass, though. Might have a big surprise towards the end. What are these? I thought these were drawings. Okay, let's go. Let's check this southern part also. Come on, man. Show me an island. Let's go a bit more and then we turn back.
You've been playing for 6 hours already.
I ate. I ate, but I left the game going, so they count that also. I mean, even if you are in the main menu, they count it as game time. So what? Where is the other one, man? A bit tight. A bit tight. A bit cheap with the space, these Anno developers. Let me just check again. So I know there are 3 islands, but I think I saw something that one is here. Let's check it out. But I understand it's not wise to get to the questing islands at the beginning. Oh, they have to be randomized, that means. Yeah, let's go to Ketema. I guess they are randomized. Let's just go there. What's over here? Sharks. Yeah, even if the others are coming here, I will buy off their islands. Even if they get... even if they get upset. Ooh. Let's talk to him, then we take a look at the island and the palace and nice this cape over here. It's very good to make the access even more cumbersome.
Your ship has returned from its voyage.
Yeah, join me guys, join your leader. I think this will be ours. Oh fuck.
As long as you preserve what's already there.
They already gave it to me. Okay, we will do that.
The many peoples of Enbesa, you must prove you can provide for them.
Okay. Oh, so that was it? That was the introduction. Super cool. What's this? A schooner. Do we need a schooner? We could use it. One influence. So this took 29 influence for this island. I need to be careful. Yeah, let's take it. We also can take this one. No, this is not for sale. This is not for sale. This is ours. So let's see. What can we buy from him? 77. I feel like we.
This city is a magnet for genius.
Sure, let's get you. And we'll buy anything you want to offer, okay. Great.
My son warns me you've a knack for
Items. Pygmy hedgehog. Animal figure. Bovine ivory. Ink ivory. Yeah, let's see if I reroll. Only three. Dig. It's tied. Pride of Enbesa, and all aspire to follow in their footsteps. It's tied to the population level, I think. We will be so much stronger together. Get out of here. Alright. Let's dump those legendaries. At harbor. Let's take a look at his harbor, man. Let's see, can I? No. I want, even though it's good like that, also. It's not that bad. Understand the island will change, the palace will change based on our decisions. Curious how that will be. Probably will grow if we take his side over here. I think new buildings will appear. But we could actually. And these are all the. Oh, this is in ruin, man. It will have to be rebuilt. Okay. I understand. New additions, new things. What's over there? King of Silly Amidas. Disappeared fast. And this is unselectable. This is. Okay. Sand kingdoms, that means Egyptians, I think.
Seven tons of red lime by order of the Empress for the new Imperial Hotel.
Church of La Corona. What else do we have here? Traditional farm. What are you saying? Modern farm. Foreigner on our farm, wonderful. Oh yeah. You need to import oil if you wanna boost the productivity. And this one? What's this one? This one can be selected. What else? What's this? This can be selected, but. Okay. Now I'm curious, guys, so I don't want to stop this vid. Let's take a look at this part. Yeah, fishing nets. All right, and this is our domain. Yeah, the animation for the animal in this game is a bit clunky. They look almost unnatural. The birds look funnier, so the birds look okay, my opinion, but the giraffes are just moving bad. What else do we have here? They are moving like they are lame on one leg. Let's see. The lions. Is this how a lion sounds? Oh, this is more like it. But this posture is good. Yeah, but the movement is iffy. These guys move natural, let's say. The hypos. I saw something over here. Here, hyenas? No. It's goats. Oh, donkeys. No. It's something. I forgot the name of this thing. This move a bit more decent, but still. I think they move too fast and that's why they look weird, though. Okay, and a rhino. I wanna see a rhino, guys. Do we have rhinos around here? Zebras? Yeah, I feel like they move a bit too fast and they turn like... Yes, let's accept this guy. Let's see how they turn. Yeah, I I guess you can't expect a level that you would get from a zoo management game, right? But I do want to see a rhino. Where would the rhino live? In a savanna? Look. Mon frère, my brother. My brutar. Come on, guys, show me a rhino. What? That was the sound of a bear, guys. What I just heard. I think they are reusing some of the sounds also. Yeah, this is how the zebra sounds. But I want a rhino. Elephants. So we saw hippos, we saw the gazelles. Yeah, they move too fast. They move too fast. And this one looks lame also. Lame means she has an injured leg. Okay. Alright, so we have elephants, we have hippos. And... Too bad you'll all be gone from this place. And a rhino, guys. I want a rhino. Don't tell me you don't have rhinos. Look, look, rhino, rhino. Rhino. Let's see them move. Yeah, this turning is weird. They turn like they are on a pedestal and you switch them. Yeah, let's say these guys move okay. Same with the hypos. Nice, nice overall. Well, you can't expect a level of fidelity. But this move weird, guys. This. They move weird. Alright, and also just to give you a sense, I actually the orangutan 3D model is a painted and a skinned gorilla model, just orange. Yeah, I think they actually redid the face, but that's just it. So some things are half done. But the amount of content in this game, I would say, allows us to close our eyes to stuff like that. They might look weird because there is no fur generation in this. See, there's no actually hair. Works or stuff like that. That's why they may also look weird. But they do move too fast when they walk. Yeah. Alright, so this is our island, which we will fill with buildings. Okay. Let's stop over here right now and we will continue in another episode. Hope you had fun. Okay, guys. For sure I did. We need steel over here. It's a hint. Yeah, I didn't think but we might need steel. In fact, let's take a look. What can I build? Weapons, yeah, it's going to be war. Only. I assume we can build something out of weapons. No, it's basically telling us that we need weapons over here. Irrigation, let's see. This costs bricks, wood. Okay, canal. Yeah, it's a new mechanic. We are going to take a look at that. One's a woodcutter. It grows its own forest. Okay. But I do know we are going to need lumber from the old world also. Okay, and that's it for now. Okay. Desert road. Small warehouse. Marketplace. Alright. Let's stop over here. I'll continue tomorrow. And I'll upload all my playthrough. Probably it's going to be unedited, so feel free to skip around during the episodes. Thanks for watching, guys, and bye bye.